Well, they say that everything's got to start somewhere. So how about starting this journeyman series here in a hotel room? And where am I? I'm in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. I've got 4 minutes to be in the lobby. The gig tonight is at a theater whose name I can't remember, but I'm sure I'll remember it when I get there. The band is going to be Vertical Horizon. First lesson, don't separate from your hotel room key. Stage pants, key in the pocket. Trying to sigh so much before the gig, and don't be late for the lobby call. See ya.
Matt, where are we tonight?
We're in Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
And there's a theater.
Yeah.
And in the hotel room, I could not remember its name, and it wasn't on my iTag.
It's
and,
called the Varsity Theater.
Varsity Theater. In Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Thank God for me.
Turn this around, maybe. Didn't turn around. Anyway, this is what it all looks like. The glamour, the glory, the dumpsters, and Mike Smith. We're going this way.
Welcome to the Varsity Theater, Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
This is Erica from Petty Betty.
Hey guys.
And she is playing at the Varsity Theater right now. And she brought these fabulous balloons. And this is
This is amazing.
That table is spectacular.
Right?
Not as good as the mirror, though. You have to admit that mirror, that has seen some shit. Welcome to the Sunday morning rush to the gate after the 5 a.m. lobby call, after the 1 a.m. back home after the show. I did have some fine chicken tenders last night. I just had some barbecue. Excuse me. So, boarding is in 2 minutes. I'm in group 3, so, you know, I should make this. It's a never-ending run. Welcome, welcome, welcome to our life. Just don't know how I'm gonna make it, you know? It's kinda rough in here. You know, desk with the band picture, beautiful view, couch, table. Welcoming plate of really neat things to eat, free drink in the fridge. It's like a mint thing on top, it's simply awesome. Kitchen, all the way into, you know, crappy little bedroom. I mean, really, gotta give me a master suite. Well, okay, so maybe there's a master suite, but we got that, and then, you know, like a bathroom. Amazing shower thing over there. Water pick next to the toilet for cleaning your teeth out. Simply awesome. Well, it's a brutal existence. Don't know how I'm gonna get through it. Welcome to the Journeyman Guitarist. It's a new YouTube channel. This is our first episode. My name is John Wesley. A little while ago, I was working on the M32C rack, and I needed to get into the software, and I was having just a terrible time with it. I was really, really struggling to get one little thing done. Other than that, the software was great. The rack was performing perfectly. And I was kind of in a crunch mode because the band I was touring with, Vertical Horizon, was going to do a gig the next week. And the pressure was on to make this piece work for our new in-ear monitor rig. And I'd kind of taken it on myself to put the whole thing together. And it was centered around the M32, this Midas rack mount mixer, which is just an amazing, amazing piece of kit. And I got stuck, and there was one critical element missing, and I didn't know what to do. I couldn't find it in the manual, and I'd searched on the forums, and I was going crazy, and I did what I would normally do. I went searching YouTube University, and sure enough, I found one really good video about that subject. I mean, I thought there might have been maybe 50 videos about it or something like that. And there was a lot of videos about the M32 itself, but nothing about that particular problem. But I found one video, and it was a young guy, maybe in his early 20s, and he was in a small bedroom, and he was just using it on a local solo gig. And he was just, he had done a series of videos on how to use the M32 software. And he had, I don't know, maybe 50 followers. The video maybe had 14, 15 views. I don't know. And it was done pretty well. You know, just had a camera. It was a one camera thing. It was probably his iPhone. But inside that little bedroom, inside that little video, was the critical piece of information that I really needed to make the gig go off, to make the show work, and to make our in-ear monitor rig that we had spent so much money on and that we were now going to be flying all over the world and depending on to get through the shows to make that piece of gear work. And it hit me as I watched him, and I realized that, you know, this guy knew that, you know, it's a crowded world out on YouTube. And I mean, it's where I get all my stuff. I mean, you know, I run Pro Tools. If I get into a jam, I go onto YouTube and find out what I'm doing wrong in Pro Tools.
I use it for lessons. There's all kinds of great guitar players out there. I'm a massive Tim Pierce fan, Rick Beato, all those guys, Rich Schull. I'll watch them I'll steal whatever I can, learn whatever I can from them. But I never thought about taking some of the knowledge that I had acquired through years of being a journeyman guitarist and putting it out there for anyone else, you know. And when I watched this young guy give me the key critical piece of information, it hit me. Well, maybe I should take this 40 years of touring that I'd had and live performing and start talking about it a little bit. And maybe there's going to be some desperate guy in his bedroom trying to figure something out, trying to learn something about how to do a show, talk to a club owner, talk to a drummer, just something, you know, some sort of piece of information, some bit of wisdom, something I might've learned along the way that might help somebody. And, you know, I already had a camera, got a whole studio, you know, and that's a whole set of stories I can get into. I used to own a recording studio and I have all that knowledge and I have all this gear. And I thought, well, maybe I should share it. And I couldn't figure out how to do that, because obviously there's the cats, you know, there's the guys that are doing it and they've got hundreds of thousands of followers and hundreds of thousands of views. And you think, how do you fit into that world? And the way I thought I would do it was I would just do it one video at a time and talk about the things that are on my mind, important to me, things that I'm doing, because I'm still touring, I'm still playing. I'm playing with a band called Vertical Horizon, and we tour. We tour all over the world, and that was part of the reason I was putting together that monitor system with that awesome piece of Midas gear. So wherever you are, young man, that showed me the key to making that software work. Now, what's even funnier than that is by learning that software, learning that little trick from that guy, months later, when we were stuck in a venue that they had brought in some production, I won't mention the place, the name, but the front of house console did not work. The production team could not make it work. Our sound man at the time, Jeff, came walking up and he was like, I don't know what to do. I'm gonna have to just try and use the monitor console that they had. And we had our little Midas rack piece with us that we were using as our monitor rig. And they had the Behringer version of the desk. And it wasn't plugged in, it was just sitting there as a spare monitor rig in case ours got lost in flight or something, or damaged. And Jeff said, I'm gonna have to make that desk work. And they tried getting into that desk and they couldn't. And then it hit me, I'm like, I bet if I get my laptop out and I Bluetooth into it with that Midas software, I might be able to access that desk. And so sure enough, I grabbed the laptop and I figured out the Bluetooth, connected with the desk, and it took another half hour of going back and forth and back and forth because the monitor engineer had a setting pressed that I didn't even know existed. And once he hit that setting and the desk and the laptop connected, boom, it saved the gig. And Jeff took the laptop out front and did a sound check and mixed the band from the laptop. And that's how we did the show. And it sounded great. And no one in the audience knew. Of course, Jeff is a super pro. And it worked. And again, I went back to this little thing just because that young guy sitting in his bedroom, playing with his Midas, hey, he figured some things out. Just because he shared that information. So at that point, the video might have had 14 views, but I was number 15. And because he shared that information with me, we got through the gig. So anyway, this that you're seeing now comes after a little montage. And the montage, I wanted to start in the beginning of 19. Oh, geez, I'm dating myself. I wanted to start in the beginning of 2024 because it's like a brand new thing. So what I did was I took a little bit of a montage of last year, some of the shows, some of the video that I did, some of running around, you know, hotels, airports, planes, trains, automobiles, and some pictures. And I put together that little montage to kind of kick it off and start the whole thing. But I'll leave it with this. I named the channel The Journeyman Guitarist because I had to take a long look back at my career and say, what is my career? I've been doing this for 40 years, I've been playing live for well over 40 years now. And I thought, you know, I've done some huge things, but in between those huge things, I've just worked. And I've gigged, and I've worked as a guitarist, and all the things that that led me to. And that's the definition of a journeyman. A journeyman is someone who works at his trade and works at his craft and makes a life out of it. And so I thought I would use that name because I think that fits me and it fits the journey that I've taken and my career path up until now. And I hope that you'll come back and subscribe, like all those things that you're supposed to do on the YouTubes, and stick with me because I'm gonna show you some stuff, and I'm looking forward to it. So anyway, John Wesley signing out. Welcome to the very first episode of The Journeyman Guitarist.